A very good morning. This is the News Minute, and you are watching News in a Nutshell. And before we start our live bulletin this morning, on behalf of all of us here at the News Minute, wishing all our viewers a very happy Ganesh Chaturthi. Wherever you're joining us from, and wherever you are celebrating the festival, please make sure that you maintain social distancing so you stay safe, your family also stay safe. And if you're stepping out, do not forget to sanitize your hands as soon as you come back home so that we can continue to be safe as we celebrate Ganesh Chaturthi. Our first story is from the state of Andhra Pradesh, where the Godavari River has once again increased in intensity, and the third danger mark is very, very close. And we understand that in two districts, that's East Godavari and West Godavari, four lives have been lost because of flooding of Godavari River. And the Krishna River too has been receiving inflow very, very heavily because of rains across Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, and because of which about 3.82 lakh cubics of water has been discharged into the Bay of Bengal. The state government as well as district authorities are keeping a very close eye on all the rivers, particularly in Andhra Pradesh and of course Telangana. And people who are living in the low-lying area have been, in fact, moved to relief camps. If you are joining us from Andhra Pradesh or Telangana and you do get any information, or if you see any photographs or videos of rain-related incidents, make sure that you do send it to us so that we can amplify it and others can stay safe. Our second story is about the legendary singer S.P. Balasubramaniam, who is continuing to be treated at a private hospital in Chennai. Now, as per yesterday evening's bulletin, the hospital did say that he continues to be on ventilator and ECMO support and is in the ICU. His condition is currently stable. Sabarimala Temple in Kerala, in fact, held special prayers for a quick recovery of S.P. Balasubramaniam yesterday. In fact, the TDB, that is the Travancore Devaswam Board, also held a special puja called the Usha Puja that was performed in the temple of Sabarimala. A musical performance was also held at the temple. Some of the old classic songs that were sung by S.P. Balasubramaniam were also sung. There was a special prayer where many people gathered and prayed for a quick recovery of S.P. Balasubramaniam. Thousands of people have been writing, with good wishes for his recovery. And we've also put out videos that you can see on our social media handles as well as our website on how several stars, several singers, several artists from across the film industries have been sending their good wishes for this legendary singer, who has a record of having sung 40,000 songs in 16 languages. And we hope that he recovers quickly and of course continues to entertain us, inspire several people across the country. Our next story is from the state of Telangana, where the Chief Minister KCR has announced a compensation to the kin of those who lost their lives in the fire accident at the Srisailam hydroelectric power plant. You might remember that on Thursday night, in fact, a fire broke out because of short circuit, and 10 people had escaped immediately, but 9 people who were inside at that point of time remained trapped. The unfortunate news is that all 9 of them have lost their lives. There was rescue operations that spanned over 12 to 14 hours, but unfortunately, the 9 people who were inside could not be saved. And the Chief Minister has announced a 50 lakh rupees ex gratia to the divisional engineer Srinivas Gaud's family and 25 lakh each to the families of the other deceased. Also, he has announced that as department-wise, a family member of each of these who lost their lives will be given a job by the state government. Our final story is from the state of Karnataka, where the language row continues, and JDS Hasan MP Prajwal Revana has also jumped into this language debate, and he took to Twitter and said that the three language policy that was announced in the national education policy is something that will disadvantage youth, particularly in Karnataka, those who fluently speak two languages. It could be Kannada and English, it could be Tamil and English. Those who are not fluent in Hindi will be at a huge disadvantage. And I read what he said on Twitter. Prajwal Revana went on to say that I will always be with you until you find a logical end to the struggle of youths who can speak two languages fluently. Let's endeavor to put an end to the trilingual policy with the central government's attention on this issue in the Lok Sabha as well as outside the Lok Sabha. So far, we've heard several politicians in Tamil Nadu come out and take this up very, very strongly. We've also heard voices here in Karnataka taking this up very strongly. It is a very emotional issue as well as an issue that is causing many claim that it is causing a disadvantage for the livelihoods and career of many youths in the southern states particularly. Will more politicians join in and demand some sort of a re-look at this policy? We will keep a track of. In the meantime, as I sign off today, once again wishing all our viewers a very happy Ganesh Chaturthi. Please remember to stay safe. The virus is still on, even as we are looking at a possible more relaxation in a lockdown, unlock 5 that is expected in a few days. Do join us again at 6:30 this evening. For now, Pooja Prasanna signing off for the News Minute.